Hi, everyone. Welcome to the fourth episode of the Better Advertising series. My name is Stevan Randjelovic. I work at GroupM EMEA as Director for Brand Safety and Digital Risk. Today, I'm joined by Jason Lambert, Head of Media Business and Internews. Hi, Jason.
Hi, Stevan. Thank you so much for having me here. I'm really pleased that you've invited me to be here today. So just wanted to tell a little bit about what we do. I work at Internews. We have the goal of advancing human progress by bringing great information to people. And when I say great information, I mean information that's based on evidence. Now, we mostly work with people who generate news, who publish news, and especially local news. And local news is the backbone, actually, of functioning society, as it holds people, businesses, and governments, actually, to account. But it's facing an extinction event right now, which is a massive problem for our society. And that problem really is about the internet giants, which are controlling most of the, or capturing most of the value from news. But it's also about this problem of so-called fake news. So is that what you want to talk about today?
Well, first, I'd like you to tell me more about the state of local news today. What is the problem and why we have it? Because we can see, I think I've seen some statistics from the US, but also from Europe, that local news are dying out because of reduction of advertising revenue. Also because people are shifting, people's attention is shifting from news to different, you know, to news aggregators. So I was just wondering if you can shine some light for our for people who are listening. What exactly is the problem? And then we can get into fake news.
Sure. Yeah. So, I mean, there has been a problem with the news business and advertising for a long time. As audiences have migrated from print and broadcast more across to digital, the revenue hasn't necessarily followed at the same rate. And that was what was called a slow motion disaster that was happening. And it was forcing news organizations to have to adopt more blended revenue models. So to look at things like subscriptions and consumer based revenues, which they should do anyway, as diversified businesses. But the problem now is that with the pandemic, that disaster has been accelerated. And what we've seen is, you know, across the globe, it's maybe 30% this year of ad revenue has been wiped, with advertisers just culling their budgets and stopping their activity. But in some of the other countries that we work with outside the US, some of those local news organizations are seeing a reduction of 80, 90% in their ad revenue, that's an extinction event. And also in the US, it's an extinction event. We've seen so many local papers going out of business everywhere, actually.
And is it because we've heard a lot, and I think since the start of the pandemics and increasingly, this is a bit of an old topic, but which was just amplified during pandemics. Is it because of the keyword blocking that what we have seen is because some advertisers are implementing very blunt tools that are not set up properly? So unfortunately, we have this issue. I suppose that is the reason. But what we as the advertising industry, you believe, can do to enforce you, and I know we've been working quite a lot together on this, so feel free, you know, to tell us about what you think advertising industry can do better.
Yeah, okay, so you're right about keyword blocking. That's been a massive issue, actually, recently, where a lot of brands have been very cautious about being adjacent to news. So for example, if they don't want to appear, or their ads to appear next to anything about COVID-19, then that, because that's so prominent in the news right now, that actually rules out most of advertising on news media, which is catastrophic for news media. So one thing that GroupM has been fantastic at, actually, with working with us and separately by itself as well, is trying to get the industry to see that keyword blocking needs to be far more nuanced than that. It needs to be much more accepting. There's so much evidence pointing to the fact that even in sensitive news or sensitive topics, hard news is a great environment for advertising. More engaged people who are, you know, really focused on the topic, they'll be more engaged with the advertising on the page and more inclined to be loyal to those advertisers that are on the page rather than abandoning it. COVID-19 coverage is so core to what we're doing right now. Everyone needs to know there is not a negative exposure to a brand by being associated with that. And GroupM has been fantastic about that.
It's always good to hear that you know we are good at something from somebody else. So thank you for the praise. Why do you think people go to fake news? Because yes, you know local and trusted news have really highly engaged users, but people still go to fake news. Why do you think that is the case? And what we can do, what you can do, to educate better people not to devote their attention to fake news websites and apps?
Yeah, I think it's a lot about media literacy. So we think that this is a problem in only some parts of the world, but it's a problem everywhere. People who have grown up with different exposure to media through social media, that, in my view, commoditizes the product. It commoditizes news. And we see that actually when we look at analytics for news media, where referrals that come to news sites from social, they'll be very, very transient, in and out, and it's a commodity product. We need for people to be much more discerning about where they find information, to find their news from reputable sources, to not share information until they've checked and understood where that news is coming from. We appreciate, of course, that can be a thing that takes time and practice, but it's worth doing so. And the other thing is to do it just to not support sites or media that pump out this kind of broadly called fake content, but that's an umbrella term for so many things. But to really focus on reputable media and make a conscious choice in supporting it.
So I think you really hit well the answer, because the answer is actually two-sided. First, we have to support the actual trusted publishers, so that and then to educate people how to find those, because at the end of the day, the facts, as tricky as it can sound, sometimes can be difficult to understand, and so people are actually more likely to go for something that is easier, not only easier to understand, but also easier to find. So we have to find a way to get people. And also, I remember I read once a research, and I think it's done by MIT, that said that people are XYZ times more likely to read and to share fake news online, simply because it's easier for them. They don't have to engage their brain to counter those things.